We are with Deacon Nick Cottrill, one of the three men who will be ordained to the diocesan priesthood on Saturday, June 1st. We are recording this several days before. Deacon Nick, welcome in.
Thank you, Frank.
As we approach the day of ordination, a day that I'm sure you thought might never be getting here, especially all those years in seminary, what are your thoughts as you get closer to that moment?
Well, to be honest with you, Frank, I'm a little nervous, but in a good way. There's underlying peacefulness through it all, just nervous in the sense of what the Lord's calling me to and the beauty of working with the people of the Lord, particularly here in the diocese, and just getting to know the Father's will in a much deeper way.
You already know your assignment. Bishop Burbage has come out with the assignments for the three new priests, and you are going to be assigned in Greenville at St. Peter's Church. When you found out about that, what were your thoughts?
I was excited, very excited. It's going to be very interesting and very exciting because we're coming in or transitioning the parish from the Passionist running it to back to diocesan. So both the pastor and assistant pastor will be coming in new. So that's exciting in that sense. And then working in the high school as a spiritual director will also be very
And when you talk about the high school, that is that is Pope John Paul II High School in Greenville, which was just started up about 3 years ago.
Correct.
And it is growing. You know, they're adding a class, a grade each year. Working with high school students, is that exciting for you?
It is, because it's something that I haven't done a whole lot of, just in terms of my pastoral assignments at the seminary, touching base with the grade schools and a little bit with youth groups, but outside of that, not a whole lot of experience, but I'm very excited to be able to do that, to work with them and get to know them.
A little bit about your background now. You were born in Akron. You even went to the University of Akron where you got your degree. So talk a little bit about your background and maybe your spiritual life at the beginning.
Okay. Yeah, we grew up in Akron, Ohio. I'm a family of three brothers, mom and dad. Dad worked at Goodyear for 40 years. And so it was very good. I was an altar boy, grew up, participated in the youth group, went to Catholic high school. And the seedbed of my vocation didn't really start there, but it was when I moved down to Raleigh in 1995. And that's when I really kind of sensed the Lord might be calling me to the priesthood, but I put it on the back burner for about 15 years before.
And when you graduated Akron, you got a degree in accounting?
Yes.
So when you came to Raleigh, you were working as an accountant.
Correct. Yeah, I came down, moved down with actually my younger brother and his wife, and got a job in accounting and worked a couple various industries and positions.
And then you start hearing the call, and you said it took a while. Talk a little about the discernment.
Yeah, it's interesting. It took probably close to 10 years to really get it to solidify. And I like to use it, I just got done running. Running away from the Lord, because I could always tell in the back of my mind that he was calling, you know. So little things would happen in between jobs or different crises in my life. Maybe the Lord's calling me to do this or to serve him in a different way. Oh, no, I got a new job. Okay, that's, you know, so it's just back on the back burner again until I got involved with the RCIA program at Our Lady of Lourdes as a sponsor first and then on the team. That I really felt the Lord calling me to do something more. And so in 2006, I met with the vocation director at the time and she said, well, this is where I'm at. And I'm not exactly sure. He said, great, that's exactly what we want. So started meeting with the discernment group through the vocations office for about a year or so. And through that process and through all of the questions and the testing and the writing, it was more of an opportunity to get to know myself better and to get to know the Lord's will as opposed to an obstacle or just another hoop to jump through. And through the whole process, I was peaceful, which never really happened in my life before. So it was something that I really felt the Lord leading me to. And the bishop was great at it, just in terms of putting me more at peace. Like, well, let's get you into the seminary, and that would be a way to discern with people that do this for a living.
Exactly.
Instead of just by myself going, well, maybe not. And then it's like, you know, so it's That's how it started.
Some men who enter seminary, their family and friends are surprised. Others say, we're not surprised. Is your family surprised, your friends?
Some of my friends were more surprised is a good word, or shocked. Not shocked, but it's like, oh, it's about, and then others, well, it's about time. We all knew it. Well, if you knew it, then why didn't you say something? Mm-hmm. You know, that kind of thing. But I think, yeah, my family's all been very supportive of me throughout the discernment in the seminary. And not only my blood family, but the friends in the Knights and throughout the diocese have been, their support and faithful witness have been
very good.
A tremendous source of.
Now, I've asked Deacon Nick and Deacon Ryan their favorite courses. I'm going to ask you your discipline, the discipline. Which was your favorite? Which one did you hold close?
My particular discipline that I enjoyed the most would be the pastoral discipline in terms of, and that's kind of a broad subject where we did apostolic work or going out into the parishes, mm-hmm. and then we had courses on all the courses with church history, patristics, counseling, the nuts and bolts of actually working in with somebody across the table or at the rectory door and meeting somebody on the street type thing was handled there, and that was something I'm much more inclined to than, you know, the hard dogmatic or systematics, which is all very good. But
where's your first Mass going to be celebrated? Where would you celebrate that?
Our Lady of Lourdes in Raleigh. That's my home parish from the first day I moved down in 95 to now.
Oh, very good.
Yeah.
Okay. As I mentioned with Deacon Ryan and Deacon Tom, the people of the diocese, and you referred to this, the people of the diocese are very supportive of seminarians, both through their support, the BAA, Bishop's Annual Appeal, but again, most importantly, through prayer.
Right.
And how important is that to you?
It's extremely important. And I could pinpoint different times through the semester where I really felt the power of prayer from the diocese and from the relationships here, particularly during exams the first couple of years where I was getting back into school after 15 years of being out. So it was a struggle in that. But in those times, like, wow, no. I have a whole diocese that's praying for me, you know, that's storming the heavens for me, you know, and the other guys, but me particularly at this time. And it was very much of an encouragement and an inspiration to me to keep going, knowing that I have this faithful witness around me and these people that love me. Many of them I don't know. And exactly. That's been something that's has sustained me.
To a person out there who thinks God is calling them, what would you recommend to them?
To pray. I mean, that's an easy answer, but seriously, just to seek the Lord's will, and not in a way that you're putting a lot of pressure on yourself, but just to seek Him, to see, okay, Lord, what are you leading me to? It might be through a conversation with your pastor or through a friend or somebody at the parish or your family, and just to seek the Lord's will and to pray before the Blessed Sacrament and to our Mother for her guidance.
Very good. Well, we wish you the best of luck.
And thank you, Frank.
As with Deacon Tom and Deacon Ryan, you know the prayers of the diocese, the faithful, have been with you, and they will continue to be with you.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.